streaming. Challenger on the radio station here. I bet you forgot who I am now, because I've been gone so long. Probably not. You guys are good radio ops, so I know you didn't forget me. Been gone a little while, mostly because of the heat. The heat was murderous, as you know. It was, whew, boy, it was something else. But we got through it another year. And now it's a little bit cooler. And hopefully it'll stay that way for a good long time. It'll get cold. But that's alright. We make videos in the cold. Have a good time in the snow. We'll get some snow. I do believe we will. Lots of things been happening. The amplifier that I was using on the radio, because you know on channel 19, if you don't have an amplifier, you're not there. Everybody and their brother has an amplifier on 19. That's the only way you're going to get heard. I don't care if you're a bass or not. So the amplifier I was using went kaput. So I went down to about 5 watts on 19, and it's just not cutting it. It ain't doing it. Nobody even knows who I am. They can't even hear me. So I've been testing out various amplifiers from various people that have been lending me amplifiers to see if I could use rear amps and maybe get back on the radio. Right now I can't afford to buy my own. Trying to keep the electric lights on so I can go ahead and maintain the radios. Because, you know, if you don't have electricity, you may have the radios, but unless you're talking on a mobile, you're not doing nothing on the base. Not unless you got a little generator, that's for sure. So I've been working on various amplifiers and various radios. It's one amplifier that I borrowed from a friend of mine. A beautiful little amplifier about the size of a cigarette pack. Real small. I couldn't believe how small. But it was super nice, but I couldn't use it because my Cobra 2000 puts out too much power. Now, the guy that builds them says, well, drop your wattage down to about a watt and a half and you'll be okay. That's true. But I don't want to do that on my Cobra 2000. I like it the way it is. I don't want to touch it. It's been that way for years and years and years and godly amounts of years. So I don't want to touch it. So I broke out one of my 142s, Cobra 142, and started experimenting with those, turning that one down. I turned it down to about a watt. Yeah, about a watt. And that amplifier I gave back because I didn't want to hurt it. It was so nice, and I didn't want to hurt it. So I just gave it back. But I got these other ones, and one's a tube type, and one's a solid state. I'll show them to you right now. Check this out. I have to get up and show them to you. All right? There they are. The varmint on the bottom. Tube type XL250. And a scorpion tube made by DNA on the top. It's got a perforated case like it has tubes in it. But it's two transistors, solid state. And this one's got the tubes. They're both very, very old. But I've been experimenting with those things. And I've got the 142 all open because I've been experimenting, turning it down, turning it up, getting it in the board right here. And some microphones work. Some of them don't. You got your JM plus 2U and your Shure microphone that normally goes on the Cobra 2000 I've got hooked up to this 142.
And so far, I've been doing a good job, but the receive is lacking. The receive really, really, really sucks on the 142. On this one, anyway. I got another one.
It's over there. And I hope that that thing receives a little bit better. And there's a big hole right here. See that big hole? Now there's an amplifier right there. That thing takes a forklift to get out of there, though. I may get it going eventually. I mean, it all I gotta do is turn it on and it goes. But you gotta key it up with about 100 watts. I may get it out, but I used to have a couple of Yaesus sitting right here. Yaesu FT-101EE and a 101 Bravo. And they're gone. I had to sell them. They didn't work. They were for repair. I didn't want to sell them, but you got to keep the electricity on, right? Put this back.
So, nothing been happening too much. I haven't got too much to say. The desk is in complete disarray, as you saw. The scanners, all the scanners that you saw earlier in one of my videos, they're all down there on the floor. All the watt meters are on the floor. The power supplies are up here on the desk where they don't belong. But I have to put them here because I'm using them to do my testing, and this 142 will not plug in to the wall. It plugs in to the power supply, like your Galaxy, like your Connex and your Uniden. Plugs in, you gotta use it with the power supply because the guy that I got it from burnt the power supply out inside the AC power supply. So he yanked it out. Oh my God. Well, that's about the size of it. The whole station is in disarray. Trying to get it back in order, but when it was real, real hot, I couldn't do nothing down here. It was too hot to stay down here. And it's just too much. It's a little bit warm down here right now, but nothing like it was, of course. And we'll be able to have some good times here in the future. As soon as I figure out how to put all this stuff back together. And maybe I'll make another video about something. I'm sure I'll come up with something. That's a nice old radio right there. The SBE Console 2. I don't know if I ever showed you that one. Everything's all in a disarray. You got Cobra 2000 sitting there being all lonely and everything. Got equipment up there that belongs down here. Got the two-piece linear amp that needs tubes. Everything's in disarray. I don't know what I'm doing. Look at this. Look at this little bad baby. Now, a friend of mine lent me this one. It's got all the heat sinks up here. It's good for about 100 watts, but I back it down to about 50, 60, and it's so clean. But it runs, of course, on your power supply. And this is another option that I'm having, but you know, I've got these three amplifiers, and there's just so many different options. I like to sound good. When they don't sound good, then I'm upset. So we'll see what's going on. But I got so much happening right now. I got a friend of mine. You know, a friend of mine named Double T. He's wanted me to go over there and help install his new base station antenna. Because he knows my specialty is antennas. I do know antennas a bit. He's in St. Charles, Missouri, where a wild man is. And hopefully we'll get him on the air soon. And he'll be on the air to talk to all of us on 19 and 24 with some good station, some good power and various jokes and good advice and words of wisdom. He's good for that. He's been a long time radio operator. We call him Double T. Heck of a good guy. That's about the size of it. I haven't got too much this time. I know it's been a long time since I've made a video, and I'm sorry for that. I meant to make quite a few, but I haven't been able to do anything. My wife is on vacation, so I've been taking her places out in the country. Just yesterday, we were out of Silver Mines Recreational Area out by Farmington, Missouri. Farmington? Yeah. Fredericktown? Farmington. And we had a very good time. We got rained on and had a wonderful, wonderful time. But I've been trying to have her mellow out and trying to get her to relax and not worry about her job so much. Trying to get her out in the woods, because that's where I go, is the woods to de-stress and mellow out. That's what I'm doing now. De-stressing and mellowing out. So that's about the size of it. Hopefully next time you see me, I'll have all this crazy crap all worked out, and you'll see the station back in order the way it should be. And me, the way it should be, so. Not much happening. This is a Delta microphone. This thing sounds good, but on certain radios it doesn't. What are you going to do? You go ahead and work, you use it, and then you don't use it. You know what I mean? You use it on the radios it works, and you don't use it on the radios that don't work. I like it, but it's got a 4-pin plug. I'm not changing that. And it won't work on this one. Works on my Cobra 29, which I was using. I dropped the power on it. I don't like doing that, you know, but if that's what it requires, then I've got enough radios I can do that, no problem. Just so I can get on the radio. Radio means a lot to me, as you know. And I will go through all the hoops, and I will do what it takes to get back on the radio, so that's the way it is. All right then, well, I'll say 73 to you. Sorry I haven't got too much to show you. When I get through with all this stuff, maybe I'll give you a tour of that varmint. I'd like to show you the inside of that thing. I think it needs a capacitor, because when you unkey it, it won't unkey. The relays pretty much stay stuck, and a few seconds later, or maybe a minute later, they'll unkey. So I think that's a bad capacitor in there, but it outputs beautifully. It's pure wattage and modulation. It's excellent because it's glass, you know. I mean, anytime you're using glass, the tubes, electronic tubes, well, you're going to hear some good modulation. And it does have good modulation, so I'll go ahead and say 73, like I said. Next video, I'll probably show you that varmint a little bit more in depth, because it is an old unit, and I'm surprised it's in such good shape. Another friend of mine let me use it, so hopefully it'll get in there, and it's a beautiful little amplifier. We'll catch you later. Challenger on the radio, saying 73 to everybody on YouTube, all my friends, and everybody in between. Like I said, sorry I've been gone. It's been a heck of a summer. Maybe we'll get a rest from all the heat. Catch you later.